In this video, I'm going to show you how to do a popular design, and that is the leopard print pumpkin. It's always popular every fall. You see it all over the place on different t-shirts. I'm going to show you how to do it in three different ways. First, I'm going to show you how to do it in Canva Pro, then Canva Free with Affinity Designer, then Canva Free with Photopea. So depending on what you have, this tutorial can work for you. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juno with Detour Shirts. I've been designing and selling t-shirts online since 2005. And in this video, I wanted to teach you how to do a special t-shirt design. And that is the leopard print pumpkin. And it's very popular during the fall. You'll probably see it all over the place on print on demand, on everywhere. You probably see it in stores as well. They come up every year, the leopard print pumpkin. So I'm gonna show you how to do it in three different ways. And depending which applications you have, you may want to try any of these. So I'll put markers on different spots on here. If you want to watch the whole tutorial, that's great. But if you want to fast forward to the apps that you actually have, you can do that as well. So the first one is going to be Canva. They're all going to use Canva at some point. And so we're going to get into Canva first, and then I'll show you how to break off and do the different things. So let's get into Canva right now. All right, so for our first one, here we are on Canva. We're gonna use Canva Pro to do a leopard print pumpkin. And I'm gonna show you the easiest way is to use Canva Pro, because if you go into Elements, click on here and type in leopard pattern pumpkin, what's gonna show up is a bunch of leopard pattern pumpkins. You don't even have to do anything. It's already here. If you have the Pro account, you can see tons of leopard pattern pumpkins. Let's take these away. I got these all there. One thing I would advise though is to make sure you don't just put this on a t-shirt. You're gonna have to combine a couple of graphics, some fonts and things like that. So you may have to do this and, you know, make it work, make it look like the same thing on a black t-shirt. I'm not gonna do one right here, but you know, it has to work together, maybe some text and stuff like that. I'll put some examples right here that I found over the internet. So you wanna make it like this, where it's not just a pumpkin, some words, some text, some flowers, something different, right? So just because you have the pumpkins right here doesn't mean that you can just use it by itself. It's on the terms of service for Canva. You're gonna have to combine things and make it just a little bit different, right? So do that, make sure to not use this by itself, but obviously, the quickest way to do the pumpkin, leopard pumpkin patterns or leopard pattern pumpkins is to just have a Canva Pro account and go through here and look. You can go to graphics, type in leopard pattern pumpkin, and you can see all the leopard pattern pumpkins here and just put them together, kind of match them together. Make sure you do the tall rectangle and have fun with this. Use different text and things. I think it will do really well for the fall, especially if you can come up with something new and exciting that's not already out there. So have fun with this one. This is the first way to do leopard pattern pumpkin, and that is with Canva Pro. So the second way to do the leopard pattern pumpkin is if you don't have Pro. Let me show you what can happen here. So I'm gonna turn off Pro. I'm gonna just do free and static and still do leopard pattern pumpkin, and let's see what comes up. You can see there aren't very many. There's this one, which isn't really a leopard pattern pumpkin. There's this pumpkin, but no leopard pattern. So there's not really a leopard pattern pumpkin for free with Canva, but you can combine them using the leopard pattern and the pumpkin together and combine them with Affinity Designer or Photopea, and I'll show you how to do it. So let's do leopard pattern first. There's this right here, and I'm gonna add another artboard. We're gonna make this the full artboard, and I'll show you why later, just so it covers the space. I'm gonna add another page. Let's do that down here, and then find pumpkin. So I'm just gonna do pumpkin by itself. And let's use this one. Let's do a couple. Let's do this one, and let's do this one right here, just for fun. I can show you both ways to do it. The reason why I like this one and this one's one solid color. We can take out the color, and this one has kind of two colors. So I'm gonna show you how to do both ways. And I'm gonna show you another pattern. So let's do like a plaid. you'll notice that they often do leopard patterns and plaid patterns together on one pumpkin or different pumpkins. So I'm going to show you how to do that. Let's just pick this one right here. It may not match, but you can see that. All right, so we got plaid, we got pumpkins, and we got leopard. So the next thing we're going to do to use this in Affinity Designer is to download this. We're going to do this, hit the download button. We're going to download all three, but for Affinity Designer, we're going to download PDF Standard. I don't think you have PDF Print for free. I think you have PDF Standard. So we're going to do that, and we're going to just hit download. Okay, so now it's downloading. I'm going to go into Affinity Designer, open these up, and then show you how to combine the pumpkin and the patterns. All right, so here we are in Affinity Designer. I have my PDF right here. You can see the three pages that we had on Canva. I'm going to take the pumpkins, these two, and I'm going to put it in a different file. I have this file right here where the artboard is 4500 by 5400, right? So I'm going to select all of these two pumpkins, and then I'm going to hit Command C for copy, and I'm going to come back to here and paste it here. And I'm going to make it the same size as this. So just so it's nice and big. I like doing vector stuff in Affinity Designer because then I have the freedom of making it bigger or smaller without having to lose any quality. Whereas if you're doing it in pixels, you may lose quality as you kind of expand the thing. So that's why I like doing vectors. I'm going to copy this artboard here so that we can do it with the other pumpkin. And let's just grab this pumpkin here and make it bigger. All right, this is going to be real easy, real quick. I'm going to take out this color because it is a vector. I can come in here, go to my layers, and you can see this right here is one color. So I can just hit delete and I can move some things around. I could make this knocked out of that. So if I wanted to, I could knock it out, but we're just going to leave it here and do it real quick right here. So let's copy this pattern. Do copy. Command C and paste it here, Command V, and you can see now I can pull this the same size. And what we want to do is we're going to do Command X to cut, and we're going to paste it in front here with Command V. So we're going to do that, Command V, and you'll notice it's right above, let me move myself, it's right above this curve here. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna pull it into it. So I'm gonna grab the leopard pattern and pull it in, and you'll see it's right there. So that's how easy you do it. We can do the same thing with this one. So let's do, since we still have it on the artboard, I think we can do Command V here, yep. And so we'll do the same thing with this color and pull it in, boom. Isn't that nice? That's a nice way to do it, kind of different colors here. Now, we could put the other pattern in these as well. So let me show you how to do that. We're going to come back here, put this other pattern, hit copy, Command C, and put it here, and Command V. And this one is going to be just a little bit different. So what we're going to do is hit Command J and duplicate this pattern three more times. So Command J. So click on this and hit Command J, Command J, Command J. So you can see there's four of them here. And there's also four of these right here. So let's just drag them into each of them. I'm going to do this, drag in. You see that? Come down here, drag it into this one. Come down here, drag it into this one. And here, and drag it into this one. And what you'll see that it went on all four of them, right? Now, if they were one piece, I could have dragged it all into one, but because there are four separate pieces, I need to do them individually. But you can see I could have done this with any different pattern. So this is kind of nice too, to kind of mix and match the patterns. So that's how easy it is to do in Affinity Designer. Once you have the pumpkins and the patterns, right? You can do it super easy with these vectors. So if you have Affinity Designer and Canva free, you can use Canva free and do this pretty easy. Now, if you don't have Affinity Designer and you're only using Canva free and want a free option, this is where we're going to do it with Canva and Photopea, but that's going to be with pixels. So we're going to go back to Canva and I'll show you how to do it. So we're back here on Canva. The different thing that I'm gonna do for Photopea, and you don't have to do this because it does open PDFs, but I just like to keep it pixel and pixel. So let's do this. Download, instead of PDF, we're gonna do PNG, and we're gonna do all three pages again. So we got the pattern, the pumpkins, and the pattern. Again, actually, let's do one change. Let's not do both pumpkins. Let's just do one and make this one bigger. We could do it with either one, but this one's gonna be easier because we got solid colors, and we'll do that. Okay, so we got the leopard pattern, the big pumpkin, and this other pattern, and let's see how to do it. We're gonna download these, so hit download, PNG, which is great, all three, and we're gonna download it. So what's gonna happen is it's gonna download all three PNGs into a zip file. Open up that zip file, and then you're gonna see the three different PNGs. So I'm gonna show you what it looks like on a Mac. It might look different on a PC. So here's my untitled. I'm gonna open it up, and if you open this, you'll see the three PNG files. We're gonna use those PNG files. I'm gonna drag them into Photopea, and you'll see what they look like. So I'm gonna put this to the side, Photopea here. Okay, so we're gonna first drag the pumpkin, which was PNG number two, drag it right here, and you can see the pumpkin. The first thing we're gonna need to do is delete the background. So let's use this magic wand here and click on the white and hit backspace or delete. So that's really easy. You can hit Command D and then get rid of those the little dashed lines that go on there. The next thing we're gonna do is drag in the leopard pattern. So that was page one of the PNG. So we'll just drag it right here. And you're gonna see that it's up here on here. I'm gonna uncheck this one so you can see the pumpkin behind it, right? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna put that pattern, that leopard pattern, in the light orange here. So let's do our magic wand again. We're gonna click on that one, hold down shift, and you can click on these as well. So just that light orange is gonna be that. What we need to do though is kind of inverse it. So we're gonna come up here, hit select, and do inverse. You could also do this shortcut key, which is shift, command, and I, but I just like using this. We're gonna do inverse, and you can see it's the inverse of it. Now we turn on this leopard pattern. Make sure that you're selected on this layer right here, not the background layer, and then hit delete. Oh, so you might have seen that it says smart object needs to be rastered first. So what we're gonna do is rasterize this. I forgot about it. This is a smart object because we brought it in. So right click on this layer and go to rasterize right here, rasterize. And now you don't see the square, so we're good. And we're gonna hit delete. And you can see it clipped everything but that part, right? So this is exactly what we saw on Affinity Designer, but now this is pixels. We can do the same thing with the other pattern. So let's get pattern three or page three. Here's the pattern. Okay, we're gonna hide it, clicking the eye. We're going to background, and we're gonna use our magic wand again, and then select the darker one. All of them, hold down shift and click on each one, and then come back here, click on that layer, turn it on so you can see it. Make sure you have the inverse on, so go to select and inverse, and make sure that this isn't a smart object to rasterize it. So let's rasterize it now that we know that, and hit delete, backspace, boom. Hit command D to get rid of those little lines, those dotted lines, those marching ants, and you can see perfect. So if you wanna turn that off, you can. Now it's its own layer, and you can turn this one off if you want, and just pretty cool. So again, you don't wanna use just the pumpkin. Well, in this case, it's different than the original, so you could use this pumpkin, but you might wanna put some words and things like that on here. So that's how you do it, three different ways. This one is the free version. It's a little bit more complicated, right? It's the most complicated, but it's free, but if you follow these steps, you can do it. It's not a vector like Affinity Designer, so if you have Affinity Designer, you can do it in that way. But if you have Canva Pro, it's the quickest way to do it. I have a link to Canva Pro if you wanna get started with that. Just so many things on Canva Pro like this. The leopard pumpkin, you can do a ton of designs with leopard pumpkins, different leopard pumpkins, leopard hearts we saw in there and all kinds of leopard pattern stuff. So Canva Pro is great if you want that variety and stuff like that, if you don't want to do this extra step. So whichever way works best for you, try it out. Hopefully this tutorial was really helpful for you. Now I'm going to make some leopard pattern pumpkins for the fall. So that is it for this video. Thanks so much for watching. Hopefully this video was really helpful for you. If it was, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed to this channel already, make sure to hit that subscribe button right there. I got lots of more videos coming in the future. You don't want to miss those. The question of the day for this video is, what applications do you have? Do you have Canva Pro? Do you have Affinity Designer? Do you use Photopea and Canva together? Let me know in the comments which applications you have. That way I can help you with your designs. If you have something different that I didn't cover, maybe I can start doing tutorials for those. So thanks so much for the comments. Thanks so much for watching. If you want to see more tutorials, click on these videos right here. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.